Good morning, everybody. Mike Vocky, PrincetonTrader.com, here for NTMarkets.com with your Monday morning pre-market webcast. Okay, happy new year, everybody. S&P 500. This is a 15-minute chart. And, you know, I did one of these for my subscribers last night. And what we talked about last night was this. You had all this congestion up here. You get the daily mid-band, weekly pivot up at 46.70. You got the monthly pivot coming in at 20.40 half. You got the 200-day exponential moving average in here, the 100-day, the 50-day. It's all jumbled up in this area between 37 and 47. And what we discussed at the time was whoever conquered this band was going to have the next leg of the market. And what we did very early on right here, right off the open, we pretty cleanly tested what was at the time the daily mid-band at 43.75. It was retested, and we ended up doing a sell area, you know, right in the 42s. And, you know, we had a 44 risk marker up top, so basically over the top of the monthly pivot and the mid-band. Figuring worst-case scenario is we get a look at the weekly pivot, but if this band, you know, if it continued to be weak and it couldn't get through, that the bears would have the next, you know, the bears would have the advantage. By the same token, if we had gone above and established 47 as support, you know, we could have seen a big move upward. Well, the bears clearly won this battle. It's been a good old-fashioned washout all night long to the tune of about 40 handles. We've been down to 98 now. We've touched that area a few times over the last half hour or so. But I haven't tried any longs. It just looked too weak. It looked weak at 25.75 when we made a little bit of a matching low. It looked weak at 20, and it looks weak at 98. Eventually, are we going to get a bounce? Absolutely. But in order for me to trade a bounce, I'm going to need to see persistent support, which we're getting here. But then I'm going to need to see some higher lows. And it really may only be a bounce up to the 2020 area that, you know, turns into another rally sell. The effect of losing this area is that it puts me in, you know, we have two baseline rules. If we're trading below the mid-band, we're in sell rallies mode. If we're trading above the mid-band, we're in buy the dips mode. The fact that the mid-band is coinciding with the weekly pivot, the new weekly pivot at 4060, I'm sorry, at 4670 and the new monthly pivot at 4060 solidifies that for me. The bulls are going to have to get through. They're going to have to do another 40 back up, and they're still going to have to do what they had to do last night when I hopped on the microphone with my subscribers. They got to get through this band. This little rainbow thing is, you know, what the market is all about right now. And the way that plays out on a daily chart is this. You know, we back this out a little bit. But here's all that congestion, right? And it's tested it, and it's failed it. So you've really got to say, you know, and I said last night, it's like a band ride without the bands. You've got all this tension here. All these key areas are built up. Whoever wins the band was going to get a pretty quick trip to either the lower band or the upper band. Well, it looks like it's the bears. So could we see some persistent weakness down here? Sure. If we're going to go down here, since we're down here, you have to say to yourself, if you're a bear, you've got to take out this low at 83.25. Maybe not today, but you need to take it out in the early part of this week and establish, you know, control over the tape by making a new low. That'll make a lot of dip buyers think twice about just blindly jumping in this market as we make new lows. We just printed as low as, well, 95, and it's still going down. So, you know, I have no interest, at least not yet. I mean, the regular session is always different, but right now I have no interest in getting along. You know, don't start, you know, grasping at straws and trying to find lows in markets like this. A lot of people, I'm sure, got hurt last night. Don't be one of those people. So let's see what it can do. But if we're down here, bears got to take out those lows. They have a clear, clear advantage, and they need to run with it. All right. Everybody have a great day. Follow us on Twitter at Princeton Trader. check out the website, come check out the chat room. I'll be back tomorrow morning with another webcast. It's a new year. I'm back from vacations. I'm here in the office. We're going to be doing these every day, just like always. I'll see you tomorrow. Trade them well.